We are going to calculate the surface area, the complete surface area, except there's a little twist in this in that it has no lid. It's completely off because the flour is about to be dumped inside. So we only have the base underneath, which is the surface we're interested in, and the complete curved surface of the cylinder. So we're going to take it in three steps. But before I tell you those three steps, recognize that all units are in meters as indicated, and we're looking for an answer to two decimal places. So let's go back to those three steps. What are the three steps? Step number one, we are going to work out the radius, which is fairly simple and straightforward because they have given us the diameter. So we're going to chop that in half to get the radius. Step number two is we're going to transform the formula. What do I mean? Well, conventional formulas for surface area of cylinders, the ones you'll find in textbooks, all include the top lid. The top lid is included. So we've got two lids over there. That's why it's 2 pi r squared. There's that component. We're going to split it up into 1 pi r squared, one circle area, because there's no lid on this, right? So we're going to change that. And then finally, we're going to drag and drop the new values into the new transformed formula and come up with the entire surface area of this giant silo cylinder. So let's start off with step number one, which is getting the radius. So down here we have 12 meters. Now, how do you turn diameter into radius? We all know how to do that. We halve it, don't we? So let's do that. Half of the diameter, which happens to be 12 meters. So the radius is 6 meters. Let me write it up just over here again. It's a pretty big radius, 6 meters. Okay, now let's transform the formula. So before we transform it, let's write down the conventional formula. It looks like this. The cylinder surface area is 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r squared. Now the 2 pi r h here is simply the cylinder surface around here, the curved surface, and the 2 pi r squared is the top and the bottom. Now we're not interested in getting the top, are we? So we're taking that off because the lid is open. So it's not going to be 2 pi r squared, it's going to be 1 pi r squared. So we're just going to call it pi r squared. There's our new surface formula, surface area formula right there. And that's for an open lid. That's the one we're going to be using now. So let's take the new value. We have a new value of 6 meters for radius. We're going to put it in there and there. We have a height already. It's a whopping 19 meters tall. It is towering. Let's put the values in there and come up with the surface area. And there's the radius, which is 6, which came from up there, which is half of that as we just worked out. So there's our 6, the radius, and multiplied by the whopping height, which is 19 meters, as you can see there, from there to there, all the way. Now we're going to add to that the pi r squared. And that's this part down here, pi r squared. Let's all work that out bit by bit. So let's work out the front part on the calculator. We're going to go 2 times pi times 6 times 19. That's the curved part around here. That's the 2 pi r h. So let's put that in there. That's going to yield us to 2 decimal places. That front part two times pi times 6 times 19 equals just this front part along here. That's the 2 decimal places, 716.28 meters squared. Now we're going to add this pi r squared here, this second part here. So let's plus that. So pi times 6 squared, which is 36, just that part there is going to give us a grand total of 113.10 rounded up, rounded up to two decimal places. Now, all we have to do now is add these two guys up, and we'll have the complete surface area of that giant cylinder. So let's do that. 716.28 plus 113.10, grand total, complete total surface area of this, excluding the lid, there's no lid on it, gives us 16 meters squared, of course, because it's surface area.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.